Hello, welcome to most important MCQ series of electronic device and circuits. The topic is physical electronics part 1 and this is the solution of quiz number 1. Okay, let's start. Okay, so question is which of the following expression may be used to correctly describe the temperature T variation of the intrinsic carrier density Ni of a semiconductor. Okay, so सबसे पहले इस पॉइंट को हमें नोट करना है कि दिस Ni that is intrinsic carrier density Ni. Okay, and what is the unit of Ni? The unit of Ni is per centimeter cube. Okay, so we can say this Ni which is directly proportional to the temperature to the power 3/2. Okay, so from the option we can conclude the option number D, which is the right answer for this question. Okay, so the intrinsic carrier density for a semiconductor which depends on the temperature, so this is Ni of T. Okay, and this is equal to A into T to the power 3/2. Okay, so where A is a prefactor. Okay, A is a prefactor, T is a temperature, and into E to the power minus Eg divided by 2 kT. Okay, so for this question number 1 the answer is D. Okay, now question number 2. Question number 2 mein pucha gaya hai the unit of mobility. Okay, so first of all what is mobility? So mobility ko hum define kar sakte hain the mu which is equal to Vd divided by E. Okay, electric field intensity. Okay, what is unit of Vd? Vd which is drift velocity. So velocity ko unit mein hum likh sakte hain meter per second. Okay, aur unit for electric field intensity ko hum likh sakte hain volt per meter. So easily we can calculate the unit of mobility which is meter square. Okay, which is meter square per volt second. Okay, so correct answer for this question. So per volt ko hum V to the power minus 1 or S to the power minus 1 bhi likh sakte hain. So correct answer for this question which is A. Okay, now the next question. So question number 3. In an extrinsic type semiconductor the Hall coefficient RH is. Okay, so what is RH? RH is Hall coefficient, and RH equal to 1 upon Q into carrier concentration. Okay, so this is carrier. Here the carrier concentration, so there is a extrinsic type semiconductor and we know that this, the majority charge carrier. Okay, so this is carrier concentration. Okay, this is carrier concentration, and the carrier concentration of the majority charge carrier, and for the extrinsic type semiconductor the majority charge carriers independent of temperature, independent of temperature. So we can say independent of temperature, we can say this RH which is the independent of change of the temperature, that is the option number C. Okay, the question is which of the following quantities cannot be measured determined using Hall effects. So we can determine using Hall effect the type of semiconductor, that is A. okay, mobility also we can determine. Okay, mobility of charge carrier, carrier concentration we can determine. So we cannot be determined which is the diffusion constant. Okay, so the correct answer is C. Okay, next question, question number 5. At room temperature the current in the semiconductor is due to. Okay, so the at room temperature in for the intrinsic type semiconductor there are holes and electrons available, holes and electrons available. Okay, so the current current in the intrinsic semiconductor which is due to holes and electrons. Okay, so the D is the correct answer. Okay, now the next question, question number 6. Which of the following will serve as a donor impurity in silicon? Okay, so donor, that means donor impurity, that means we required fifth group element, and we know that there is a fifth group element, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Okay, so D which is the right answer. Okay, next, which one of the following pair of semiconductors and current carriers is correctly matched? Okay, so option A is, there is an intrinsic type semiconductor, the number of electrons equal to number of holes. So this is the right one. Okay, this is the right pair. Now for the option B, the p-type semiconductor, the number of electrons is greater than number of holes. This is the wrong. So there is a number of electrons, suppose the concentration of electrons indicated by N and concentration of holes indicated by P. So for the p-type semiconductor, the concentration of holes which is greater than concentration of electrons. Okay, so this is the wrong option. Okay, now for the n-type semiconductor, okay, the number of electrons N which is greater than number of holes. Okay, so again, C is also the wrong answer. In the case of bulk, there is neither electrons nor holes. This is also the wrong option. Okay, so the correct answer is A. The question is, n-type semiconductor, okay, the option is, are negatively charged. We know that the semiconductors are neutral device, so that's why this is the wrong option. Next option is, are produced when indium is added as the impurity to the germanium. Okay, so n-type semiconductor, that means we require donor impurity. Okay, so we know that previously I have written donor impurities, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Okay, so there is an indium. Okay, so indium belong to third group element. Okay, so this is also the wrong option. But in the case of third, C option, are produced when phosphorus is added. Okay, phosphorus added, which is which belong to fifth group element. So that's why C is the right answer. The drift velocity of electron is in silicon is proportional. Okay, so we required a very important graph between electric field intensity and the drift velocity Vd. Okay, and this graph which is like this. Okay, so there is a linear region, this is linear region, this is sublinear region, and this is saturation region. This is sublinear, okay, and this is saturation. Okay, so it's proportional to the electric field for all value of electric field. So we know that in the case of electric field, this Vd is directly proportional to the electric field, but when the E, which is small, for E is small, this is valid only for E is small. So this option is wrong. Is independent of electric field, this is also wrong option. Increases at low value of electric field, yes, and decreases at the high value of electric field, exhibiting negative differential resistance. No, this is also the wrong option. So the option D is, increases linearly with electric field at low value of electric field and gradually saturates at the higher value of the electric field. So this is the right option. Okay, so D is the correct answer for option question number 9. So the question is, the concentration of minority carriers in an extrinsic semiconductor under equilibrium is, so suppose we have n-type semiconductor, for example, so the minority carriers are, the carriers are holes, okay, and the majority carriers are electrons. Okay, so using mass action law, we can write this n into p equal to ni square. And what is n? N is the donor concentration, so nd. So we can say the minority carriers are ni square divided by nd. Okay, so it is inversely proportional to the doping concentration. Okay, so the option number B is the right. Okay, next question is question number 11. Consider द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट इफ एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज अप्लाइड टू एन एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर बार द इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड होल मूव इन अपोजिट चार्जेस द नेट करंट इज ओके सो द सिचुएशन इज लाइक दिस देयर इज अ एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर दिस इज एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर ओके एंड वी अप्लाइड अ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड हियर across the n-type semiconductor okay so for the n-type semiconductor electrons are in majority charge carriers and holes are minority charge carriers okay so when we applied this electric field okay so electron will attract okay like this and hole will move away from this point okay or we can say it will attract by the negative terminal of the battery okay so the net current is due to the both electron and hole with electrons as a majority carriers okay so this statement is true okay there will be a net current which is due to the electron as well as holes okay the second is the sum of electron and holes current okay so this is also the correct option but the point is third is the difference between electron and holes current okay so third statement is wrong so we can say or statement number 1 and statement number 2 are correct so B is the correct option the next question number 12 for the n type semiconductor with n equal to nd and p equal to ni square by nd the hole concentration will fall below the intrinsic value because sum of the holes to the acceptor impurity states drop to donor impurity state virtually leave the crystal recombine with the electrons for the n-type semiconductor we know that this hole concentration this is the given part actually this hole concentration which is equal to ni square divided by nd okay so this hole concentration which is below this particular ni okay so the reason is a recombination it will recombine with the electron that's why the hole concentration which is decreases question number 13 the mobility of electron in a semiconductor is defined as the okay so the mobility is mu which is the drift velocity vd and electric field E this is the ratio of the VD and E so the drift velocity per unit electric field this is the correct option so answer D is the right option in the Fermi state statics the probability of electron occupation of an energy level equal to the Fermi level is okay so we know that the Fermi Dirac function which is indicated by F which is equal to 1 upon 1 plus e to the power e minus ef divided by kt where we need to calculate the probability of electron occupation of an energy equal to the Fermi levels that is e equal to ef okay so here we can put this value so 1 plus divided by 1 plus e to the power e f minus e f that is 0 so this is equal to 1 by 2 so the correct option is c that is 0.5 this is the c is the right answer okay now the next question is if the drift velocity of holes under a field gradient of 100 volt per meter is 5 meter per second so vd is given vd is 5 meter per second and the field gradient that is E equal to 100 volt per meter so what is mobility the mobility is VD divided by E that is 0.05 the correct answer is A okay now the next question is in a p-type semiconductor the conductivity due to holes is equal to okay so the conductivity that is sigma p which is equal to p into q into mu p so q is actually e so p into u into mu p okay and the conductivity due to electrons are n into q into mu n. Okay, so total conductivity we can write sigma p plus sigma n, okay, which is equal to n into q into mu n plus p into q into mu p. Okay, so for this question the correct option is C. Now the next question is, the minority carrier lifetime, that is tau, which is given, which is 100 microsecond, and the diffusion constant, which is d, so d equal to 100 centimeter square per second. Okay, the diffusion length, that is we required L, and we know that the L is under root of tau into d. Okay, so where tau is 100 micro, that is 10 to the power minus 6, d, that is 100. Okay, so there is a, okay, so there is a centimeter, so here centimeter, so no problem with unit. So this is 10 to the power 4 into 10 to the power minus 6, so which is 10 to the power minus 2, and root, square root, so that's why this is 10 to the power minus 1. Okay, so the correct answer is A. Now the next question is, the conductivity of intrinsic semiconductor is, so we have conductivity is n into q into mu n plus p into q into mu p, and we know that for the intrinsic type semiconductor, the n number of holes equal to number of electrons equal to ni. So this conductivity written as n sigma I, which is equal to ni into q into mu n plus ni into q into mu p. So we can write this is ni into q into mu n plus mu p. So the correct option is, okay, so correct answer is C. Now the band gap, what is band gap? Band gap is the gap between EC and VB. EB is maximum energy for balance band and EC is max minimum energy for conduction band. So this is the band gap. Okay, this is band gap. And for silicon, band gap, okay, so for silicon this band gap equal to 1.10 electron volts. So V is the right answer for this question. Now the question number 20, there is a material. Okay, so there is a material and the band gap, so we know that for the metal there is a zero band gap. Okay, for insulator there is high band gap. Okay, for semiconductor, which is the band gap which is in between 1 to 5 electron volt. Okay, so we can say this is connected with C, and for the semi metal that is a B. Okay, so for A there is 4. Okay, then B that is 2. Okay, so A is the right answer. Okay, so I hope all questions are clear. Okay, thank you.